Welcome to the podcast where I'm not gonna have fun doing my quiz. This is podcast 232, and we are going to do a quiz, and it's going to be my quiz. Do I feel happy about hosting? No, I'd rather be a participant. I'm not even gonna lie. I'd rather be a participant because I always feel bad after the quiz that I do, especially the last one where it was all ridiculousness. But nevertheless, this is me, Dark Boo, and I'm joined by SpiderStaryu.
Hello, everyone. I'm everyone's favorite first place alternate.
Oh, please.
SuperZambezi.
Hi. Boo, your quiz will be fine. Don't worry.
Last time that happened, never mind. And so...
I'm here. Hi. Hello. I'm present.
And that gave me a what happened?
Well, we might potentially have an extra guest.
Shut up.
The screaming kids outside.
Oh my god.
Potentially.
I knew you were going to say it.
These kids outside are going to drive me crazy, okay? I can't get rid of them. I can't get rid of their voice. If I get rid of their voice, I get rid of my voice. Oh man, so bad. But nevertheless, yes, this is going to be another quiz show, and I'm going to host this one. I hope everything goes well. I pray everything goes well. But let me just get into what it is. It's only 25 questions. I thought about having 50, and then I thought about how lazy I was, and the laziness won, okay? These kids! Oh, my God!
Hello.
I can't. These poor, these kids. They should be in school. They got AP, not AP, Regents exam. But nevertheless, 25 questions. There are 5 categories, and the categories are Nintendo headquarters, meaning most of the questions are centered around Nintendo itself. And I really mean Nintendo
itself. Like the company.
Yes. We're going shopping, and this one is a unique one. There's going to be each question, I'm just going to give you items, and you got to basically determine how many coins you need in order to use these items or buy these items, because Mario Party 5 you had to have coins to use them, and the other Mario Party you just need to buy them. We have Anagram Boss Battle, which is basically, I give you a hint about the boss, it's a character in the Mario game, no other game, that you have to determine the boss name by basically using the anagram that I have. There's gonna be 2 that y'all gonna laugh at. Zelda Historia, this one, you gotta be careful with this one, because this one is actually, it's in-game, the in-game things, so you're gonna have to figure out probably a game or a person, and there is one awful question that is actually a cutscene.
Don't go into it too much.
And then I have Pokemon with an ellipse at the end. Ellipse of 3 dots at the end. Okay, this one is not going to be my favorite reading it, because I gotta make sure that I read things properly. But this one, like I said, mostly is I love these kids.
They're amazing.
Oh my god, 3 out of 5 are cutscenes, and the other 2 are, I mean, not cutscenes, they actually from the TV show, which I feel like everyone should know, I hope, especially the ones that are in the cut. No, it's only 1 that actually from an anime.
Okay, good.
The others are from the game.
Good.
And with that, we can actually get started. So 5 categories: headquarters, shopping, boss battle, Historia, and Pokemon. And I read the letters out for the anagram boss battle as well as post it, because I can't read the words. I can read the words, but eh. And so by random chance, and it's good that he's going first so I can make the scoreboard. Ezzy, you can choose one first.
Okay, we can do a Nintendo headquarters. I'd like to try that one.
Ooh, all right.
Oh boy. Nintendo headquarters. I just do the questions from 1 to 5, so it's basically not which one to choose. Okay, the first one. Oh, this one is a fill in the blank. It's a quote.
Okay.
The blank is basically the person who said it. My name is blank. I'm about kicking ass. I'm about taking names. And we're about making games. And I know everyone sent that in, and I don't know who sent that
first. I think it's the bottom one is the one who sent it first. Or, yeah, on your recents.
Okay, 243.50. Let me check this one. 243.51. 53. Okay, so Soul sent it first.
Ooh, ooh. Sing it.
Yeah, 243.50. Soul sent it first, and yes, it is Reggie.
We all got it right.
Yes, everyone got it right. That was May 2004 E3 press conference, by the way. Yes, I have the name there, just in case anybody asks me a question, if I knew it. I didn't know that.
Can you?
Let me put that out there. I didn't know that.
Can you imagine him saying that now?
Oh, God.
No.
No, yeah, see, that's it's so different. It's so weird.
I cannot. Different approach. And so, I forgot how you do the points before. Is it 2-1, or is it 3-1?
It's up to you. Yeah. How do you want to do it?
It's probably 2-1, whoever got it first.
Honey Budgets, how you did it before?
Oh, my.
Person who got it right gets 2 points, and everyone else who gets it right gets 1 point. If you send in first, you get 2.
Okay, so I'm gonna do that until it's one of those special categories. So yes, it was Reggie, and everyone got it right. Mm-hmm. I would have got it wrong if you want the truth. I'm not gonna lie, I would have got it wrong. Oh boy. And so, with Soul with 2 points in first, Soul is your
turn.
You can choose category.
I'm gonna choose shopping. That shopping one.
Ooh.
Oh, yay. You know I love math, so this is my favorite.
Oh, God.
Out of all of them. Me. You basically, you're going to have to take out a calculator just in case. Because you're going to have to add, it's mostly 3 or 2 items that you're going to have to add up the prices.
Okay.
So you might as well take out the calculator.
Right.
Okay, so we're going shopping in Mario Party 5. Mm-hmm. You need to tell me the total amount of coins you need to be able to use these 3 items.
Oh, no.
Bob Omb Capsule, Piranha Plant Capsule, and Coin Block Capsule.
Dang. Oh, God. Why did I do this? I don't know anything about prices in these games.
Same. I don't remember anything. Hopefully I got it right.
That's in coins, by the way. I don't...
One more person.
Dun, 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 dun.
Okay. Oh. SZ, you definitely sent it in first. My, no, what? Only Honey Bunches was close.
Oh my God. Oh my How bad goodness. Was I?
Ironically, you and SZ chose 35 coins.
Hey.
Wait, didn't you say the bomb? Didn't you say the bomb?
Yes, the bomb.
Isn't the bomb free?
Yes.
Slay! I got it. I don't think I got it right, but I was close.
You were the only one close. You said 15.
Dang.
And that was the only closest one. You won't believe the Piranha Plant only cost 5 coins.
What?
Oh, yeah. To use it on yourself. Why would you want to, though?
Yeah, to use it on yourself, it only cost 5 coins. The bot on castle is 0.
I did not.
Wow. Piranha Plant is 5 and Coin Block is 5. So in total, 10 coins.
So if you use the Piranha Plant on yourself and you lose half your coins, it just disappears? It doesn't go into anybody?
No, it doesn't go to anyone, period.
Go back to yourself?
It doesn't go to anyone, period, in that game. That game is stupid.
I see no possible reason for that to happen. Like, unless you think someone's going to steal your coins and you really don't want them to. I don't know.
No, I made a mistake and do it, so... Yes, I made a mistake because I was falling asleep. And that game is boring. But, like I said, the bomb arm was a throw-off because it was 0. And Piranha Plant was 5. I thought Piranha Plant was 10 when I first did that. I thought it was 10 until I researched it and it was freaking 5. And I'm like, who still used that thing on themselves? Luckily, they didn't program the computers to do that. Oh, so no one got that right. Honey Buzzes was the 3rd to send it in. Ezzy was 1st, Soul was 2nd. But Ezzy and Soul had the same value, 35.
The same wrong value.
I was thinking 10, 10, and 15, or something like that.
for a coin block at six?
I don't know. I don't even remember what a coin block does.
Oh, God.
It gives you 10 coins. Can I go next? Because we need to erase that nonsense.
Yes. Okay. You can choose category.
So I want to choose the Pokemon category.
Oh, something yes, I can succeed
in. Yes, God. SpiderStaryu. Yes.
Okay, Pokemon. Okay, first one. This is more of anime. This is the first anime question of it.
Okay.
This Pokemon, well, three of them, annoyed Pikachu to the point where he learned Electro Ball.
Oh my gosh. You have to name all three?
I have no clue.
Are they all the same species?
All three of them are the same species.
Okay.
It's one Pokemon name.
Oh. I think I got this right.
I just sent it in. I don't think I got this one right. I don't even remember.
Oh, okay. Only Soul got it right.
Oh, we got it right.
What was it?
Soul said
it was. I was right,
and that's correct.
Yes,
that's correct.
I remember there were three of them, and I was like, "What's?" I know Electro Ball is from the fifth generation because that's when the move was introduced. So I just took a guess.
Oh, I said Magnemite. That's not right.
27, 26.
A.
And 249. Oh, wait. 01, 27, 26. Okay. Honey Bunch was the first to send it in. He said Magnemite, and that's not correct.
Aww.
As he said Butterfree, that's not correct.
Oh, God.
And Soul was the only one to say Duck.
A.
Yay!
Yeah, oh, someone's upset already. Someone's bitter.
I would have got it wrong.
I'm surprised someone got it right because I don't remember Ducklet at all. Because Ducklet is such a boring Pokemon.
Yeah, it is.
I remember Psyduck because Psyduck serves me, but Ducklet is like, ugh.
Yes, everyone remembers Psyduck because that is. Don't keep no secrets from me. That is still iconic. Okay.
Do you know what noise Psyduck makes, Boo?
Noise. Only thing I like in any show is when he uses psychic. That's the only part I like. Is it psycho or is it confusion? No,
I might be confusion. Maybe. I don't even know because confusion is a move. If you guys don't know,
yeah,
confusion.
Does he even learn confusion?
I think it does.
I know it when it gets a headache, it does.
Yes.
Speaking of headaches and Pokemon, let's move on to the next question.
Speaking of headaches and Pokemon, let's talk about SZ.
SZ.
So, what's a category that hasn't been used yet?
Anagram Boss Battle or Zelda Historia?
Zelda Historia.
Ooh. Oh, I'm not getting any points this time either.
Okay, this one. Oh boy. What is the song that you have to play to heal to heal and cleanse Sharp Soul, the composer brother?
What?
Say that one more time.
Can you repeat it?
What is the song that you have to play to heal and cleanse Sharp Soul? Sharp is a composer brother.
I might have got it wrong.
Stop
but
it!
I don't know.
Stop it! Nope. Delete what you wrote.
I don't know.
Oh my God, so you're going to have to be specific.
Is that right?
You're going to have to be
specific. I don't know what it's called.
Be harsh. Be harsh. Lay down the law.
There's two songs that I think. Actually, no, there's one song, and that song is wrong if I think about it. That's what I'm saying. Because if it is the song that I think it is, it's wrong.
What, you don't know the answer?
I do know the answer. Oh. And y'all chose the trick answer. Because my little note here is that the game tricks you and make you think it's the Song of Healing.
Is it the New Wave Bossa Nova?
No.
What? The heck? What?
At least you know it's Majora's Mask. It's the Song of Storms.
What?
Well, okay, so I was definitely wrong. That was not close.
I don't understand. Song of
Storms. I said this is the one where you raise the sun.
Yeah, I thought it was Sun Song he was talking about.
The composer. I was thinking of the Zoras. Yes.
I knew that from a Brawl in the Family comic.
That's Mikau.
Dang I know it. Nothing about Zelda, so I don't. I wasn't tricked. I just didn't know.
I didn't know either.
Dang it! Dang it. The music box. Yeah, if you said the music box or something, I would have known instantly. Oh,
you tricked SZ.
That's why I said the name because the game actually make you think it's the song of healing too. It just cuts and say, oh, it doesn't work. Oh.
I was wondering, like, when do you ever go to those, like, the Zora band members, and when do you play, like, songs to them? I don't remember that. Wow.
Oh, that was Mikau. The names are the killers. And that was Aziz, so I think so.
Oh. You're next. I want to do, since we've done 4 out of the 5, let's do that boss battle thingy with the other thing.
Okay. This is an anagram. I'm going to post the anagram after I... You know what? Let me dual screen this so I can post it at the same time.
Dual screen? What?
Yeah, on my computer. Just have 2 windows up at once. Okay. This is two words. So basically, the boss will be 2 words. Like, his name has 2 words, basically. Beware this dog. Good things he mounted on a wooden post. Macho pinch. It's an anagram.
Wait, say it again? I didn't hear a word you just said.
Yeah.
Beware of this dog. Good thing he's mounted on a wooden post.
Got it.
What? A wooden post?
Ezzy, you should know this.
Mm-hmm.
I have no clue, so I'm just gonna say.
Oh, dang it.
So you got it right, by the way.
I know.
We went on Ezzy.
I sent it in.
Dang it,
fine! Oh, time is something!
Yeah, come on, you don't get that long.
Okay. Oh, so got it right, and he was the first one to send it in. Chain Chomp!
Oh my goodness, no. You cannot be serious. It's Chain Chomp. Mounted on a wall, you said?
A post! Wooden you post. Even said a post!
No.
A wooden post.
Nope.
Dang. Nope. I wish I got that.
Read my answer.
But.
Yes.
Oh, we should get points.
I should get a point. Yeah. I should get 2 points.
Get out of here. I should get 3.
Please. My answer is that everyone loves my answer.
If you rearrange the letters, you get Chain Chomp. Oh my God.
Was that a Chain Chomp?
Goodness, it's not like a Chain Chomp, it's chasing them. And if you want to know which type of boss he was from Mario Party 9.
Chained to a wooden post, I'm like, okay, that's a Mario thing, and it's obviously the Chain Chomp. That's the only thing I could think of.
Yes, it's the only... All of them are going to be Mario, by the way. None of them are going to
be Mario. Well, I wish you had made that clear, because you didn't make that clear at the beginning.
They'll be all Mario. Okay, yeah, I was thinking like Zelda over here.
That could have been anything. Yeah. You should have made it more clear at the
whatever.
Beginning. Whatever. Only Mario.
Moving on.
Honey Bunches.
Gosh.
Pokemon again.
Okay. No. Pokemon. Let me scroll to the right. Pokemon. Oh, nice. This is a nice one. You just got to identify the person.
Cool.
Please let me read this, because if I read the first line, you're going to think the current generation. She is an inspiring Pokemon coordinator. Her parents are Norman and Carolyn.
Repeat, please, one more time.
She is an inspiring Pokemon coordinator.
Oh, darn it, so you already sent it in?
Yeah.
Yes, he did.
Damn it, he got it first.
Her parents are Norman and Carolyn.
This is a anime thing, SZ. Norman... Wink, wink.
Don't help him out.
I'm gonna help him out.
What are you doing?
I'm nice.
Okay, so you better help me out next time.
Oh, maybe.
So, sent it in first, he said May, and May is correct. May is definitely correct. I'm sorry, Ezzy. And I wrote for him. Her brother name is Max. It's May. And Soul sent it in first. Honey Bunches sent it in next.
So I got another point. So I have 2 points.
Mm-hmm. Oh,
what did he say?
Read
it.
He said Misty.
I'm so sorry.
I'm
wrong. I don't know.
I'm so sorry. I would have never guessed Misty, though. I'm sorry.
I had no other word to come in my head. I think I'm having trouble hearing, because you said Pokemon coordinator.
Yeah.
Misty's not
then
a Pokemon
I don't know
coordinator.
What that is. I don't know anything.
So, Honey Bunches chose that, so it's back to SZ.
Can we do a score update?
Okay. Okay. First place is Soul with 7 points.
Wow.
Woo! SZ has 1, and Honey Bunches has 2.
Oh, okay. If I at least get second, I'm good. I need to defend my place.
my
So, Essie?
So we've gone through all the categories.
Yes.
Let's do another Zelda one. I need redemption.
I'm gonna kill myself.
This one's... Y'all make it. Which Zelda game was laced with controversy facing numerous Islamic features?
Nope.
I sent it in first. You better know that I sent it in first. If Essie only spelled like one word, and that's not fair, because I spelled the whole thing.
That's your fault for taking time to do
that. That's ridiculous. So he gets his point. Oh my god, whatever.
As long as you get the point across, you got it.
And Essie sent it in 4 seconds early. But he did. It is what Honey Butcher said. He put OOT.
Oot. That's ridiculous. I spent the whole thing out.
That's... I'm sorry, but that's...
That's ridiculous. Alright, whatever. Give Essie a pity point.
Excellent. Oh my god. I need the pity points.
Yes, Essie, he gets 2 points. So, I let Soul do that one because he actually named the temple. He said Fire Temple, okay? So that's why I told Soul the game.
I zoned out. I had no idea what happened. It's like, I heard Zelda and Islamic references. It's like, Fire Temple.
So, by the way, next time the answer is like Mario Party 6, I'm just going to write M6, because that's how we're playing it. So, M6.
MP6.
Oh, no, M6, because that's how we're playing it. M6, that gets the point across.
So, everyone got it right.
Hooray.
Okay, and I said the Islamic feature was Fire Temple, Allah, Prayer, and the Mirror Shield. That's if I wanted to get really technical. So, everyone got it right. So, Soul, it's your turn.
Okay, I want to do the boss battle one again.
Oh boy. Okay.
Oh boy.
Let me copy this word before I read it. Damn kids go driving me crazy. Okay. We're talking about rocks and space here. Kind of spooky.
Uh-huh.
And it's one word. So when you take, when you rearrange all the letters, it should make one word because it only has one name. Okay, Giblet Rouse.
Yeah, I knew this one. I knew this one. You said rocks in space, and it was a Mario boss. I knew exactly what you were talking about.
Oh my god.
You gotta be spelled right, too.
Oh, I don't know. Wait, no one person.
Who sent it in first?
Me.
So.
I sent it in.
We gotta get what?
I don't know. I don't play Smart Galaxy.
Oh! I'm sorry.
He's wheezing.
The answer is both the case. Essie and Soul got it right, but Soul sent it in first.
Dang, I had it before you even finished talking, and I was waiting for you to post it, and
I'll just abbreviate it next time.
No, it doesn't work like that.
Yeah, no.
It works so far.
Should I say
titles?
His,
yes.
Should I say his answer?
Go ahead, say it.
Honey, but...
What did he write?
I said Yoshi Man.
When I realized I read rocks in space, that took me away. I'm sorry. Oh Lord. Oh my god. Super Mario Galaxy is the boss. And do I have the place where from? No, it just says Super Mario Galaxy. It was Boulder, guys. So, Honey Bunch is... I think... Yeah, it's Honey Bunch's turn, right?
Yes, because I went.
Pokemon okay. again.
Okay, Pokemon. Oh, that's a giveaway question. My goodness.
Don't say that. Oh, no.
It is. How many evolutions are there?
Oh god. I hope I got that right.
Ezzy sent that first.
Ooh. Let's see if I got it right though.
Evolution, so Eevee doesn't count, right?
No, it doesn't count.
Alright.
It is 8. It's 8. Ezzy sent it in first. Yeah, it appeared very first before anyone. It's 8.
Wow, that's the first and only Pokemon question I will ever get.
Oh, should I try pronouncing them?
Yes.
Oh boy. Jolteon, Vaporeon, I hope Flareon, Espeon, Glaceon. What? I was supposed to read that? Sylveon? Leafeon? I can't pronounce that. Umbreon? Did I pronounce them right?
I think so. You shouldn't be asking me.
I hope I pronounced them right, but everyone got it right as Z sent it in first. So that's 6.
Wow.
11-4. Oh boy. Lucky I named them all right, because if I didn't, it would have been quite sad. So, should we do a score update?
Mm.
Yeah, we could do that.
First place, Soul with 11. Dang. Second place, SZ with 6. And third place, Honey Bunch, who was 4. That's the current scores. Oh, boy. So, I think Soul is your turn to choose the category.
I'm going to choose...
Wait, no. Is it Soul? Who
wait,
goes
no.
first?
Sorry, just my... It's SZ.
Okay, so it's
SZ.
Me. Nintendo Headquarters.
Yeah, I was going to choose that one, too, so I guess...
Oh, my God.
Oh, no.
Oh, my God.
Come on. Lay it on us.
Ooh.
We can do it.
I don't expect no one to get this. This is too hard.
No, we can do it.
Do I get... Oh, okay. Don James' wife's name was Polly James. This gave inspiration for Miyamoto to name this kidnapped woman this name.
This kid... What?
Kidnapped woman. And SZ sent it in first. Wait, 305-01-305.
No, don't question it. Don't question it.
Yes.
Just go with
because yours appears first. I was looking at the chat anyway, and yours appeared first. Yes, it is Pauline. I thought, okay, so it wasn't a hard question because I thought that was ridiculous. But okay. Thank you that wasn't a hard question. Because I was going to be so mad if it was hard. And yeah. Everyone would be like, what? Oh, thank you. You boosted my confidence with that question. And I thought that was the hardest one out of that category, okay? So everyone got it right because everyone said Pauline. I would have never got it right.
Well, I heard Polly. I just kind of guessed.
I would have never got it right.
You probably... What about just based on the question? You could probably get it right. Like, you know who the character is, right?
Yes.
Shout out to Paul.
Oh my Lean. God.
But I would have never thought Pauline at this time during the quiz. So, your turn.
Let's do Nintendo Headquarters again.
Okay. This one, I worded it because if I give the name of it, it's the answer. Let me see.
Okay.
Okay, yeah. This console was called a family computer in Japan. It also has an abbreviation that will easily give away the answer to this clue.
I already sent it in after the first sentence.
Oh my gosh. I mean, it's...
Easy.
Oh, no.
Ezzy, you better get this. This is an easy question.
Sorry, did you say in Japan only?
Oh my
basically?
God. In Japan, it was known as the family
like
computer.
Seconds.
Its abbreviation might give it away to what system it is.
Oh gosh, I changed it to the right answer.
I'm going to give for both of them if you said Famicom or NES.
Sweet.
Okay.
So the answer, Honey Bunch sent it in first.
Dang it.
The answer was, it was NES. You could say Famicom. Because
good.
I didn't realize until now that means two answers.
2 points so everyone, for me.
Mm. Yes, everyone got it right. Everyone, okay. So the I would have got it wrong. Would have got it so wrong. I feel so stupid
no,
now.
Don't say that.
It's true, Ezzy. I would have butchered it. Okay. Y'all easing through it. Oh man, Honey Bunches. You can choose a category.
Pokemon.
Oh, Pokemon!
Oh, no.
This is the fourth question. I'm gonna get the region name wrong, okay? So can I spell it? No, I'm gonna try to say it. By population, which area is the largest in the Kalos region? Did I say that
yes.
right?
Yes. Population.
Yeah. Sentinel.
Mm-hmm.
If I spelled it wrong, it doesn't first. Matter. It doesn't matter if it's abbreviated, so it's good.
You sent it in first too.
Like a city, town, population.
I said, by population, which area is the largest?
Okay.
Okay.
I think.
And my hint for myself was obviously the metropolitan area. Oh my god, I gotta pronounce it.
Actually, I might have gotten it wrong. I want to know what it is.
Lumio City.
Oh. Wait, so I got it right?
Everyone got it right.
Cool.
Yes, everyone got it right. Honey Bunches sent it in first.
Yes, yes, about time. Yes.
So, 14. Okay. So everyone's flying through the court. I would have got it wrong. I don't even think I have the game, okay?
You think?
It's on the 3DS.
I know have the game now. Okay. Thank you. Oh my goodness. That's quite sad. I can't do that because if I don't know.
Oh, wait. You said you think.
You think.
Are you saying that you have a 3DS and you have Pokemon and you're a big Pokemon fan and you're waiting for Sun and Moon?
Not true.
I knew it this entire time.
Not true. It's not true. No. I plead the fifth. Actually, I plead the fifth. With pleading, Honey Bunches just win. Aziz, your turn.
You know, I was actually thinking we should let the kids outside get a turn.
Shut up!
Because they're our guests. Just stick your microphone out the window and let them.
You don't have to stick it out the window.
I'll do. What's the category with the least used?
With the least?
Mm-hmm.
It's actually we're going shopping.
Let's do that one then.
Okay. You might have fun with this one. God. It's Mario Party
3. Oh, God.
Oh.
Oh, no.
So there's three items. The three
go.
Items.
Go, yes.
The item bag, golden mushroom, cellular shopper.
Oh.
How much they
ooh,
cost?
Ooh. Oh, yes. You said cellular shopper, golden mushroom, and item bag.
Mm-hmm.
So the price combined, right?
Mm-hmm.
All right, good.
I don't know how much the cellular shopper is. Oh, shoot. A golden mushroom. Oh, no.
Only Honey Bunches got it right.
Oh, I know I got it wrong. I'm guessing.
And he sent it in first. Oh. 45 coins.
Dang.
Although
30, 10, and 5.
Mm-hmm.
I forgot. I thought golden mushroom was 20. That's Smart Party 2, yep. Right?
My answer key was definitely corrupted. It said 50 because I had another item there before cellular shopper. But it is 45. I remember those prices, too. And... as he said, 60. How?
I thought it was 30, and then 20, and then 10.
Oh, you thought it was the inflated Mad Party 2 prices?
Yeah.
And so said 25.
I was guessing, okay? I don't know anything.
I'm not going to question that 25 when the item bag is 30, and it always been 30. I'm not going to question it.
Well, so goes to the trashy shop, so usually those are the ones that
yeah,
least expensive.
I just get, like, the leftovers that people throw out. Like, when I'm talking about the item bag, I literally just get the bag, like, nothing in it.
Or an item bag with, like, just skeleton keys.
Ooh. Oh.
Three skeleton keys.
Oh, boy. So, wait.
Yeah, it's my turn.
Yeah, so.
I'll do the Zelda one, even though I don't know anything about Zelda.
Okay. Whew. Zelda. I wouldn't know the answer.
Are you? God.
I'm not lying, because I wouldn't know the person's name. As Link was the royal servant of Zelda in Hyrule, this person was the royal servant of Hilda in Lorule.
I think it's this person is what you're, like, looking for.
I'm probably definitely wrong. Okay, before Boo reads my answer, understand something. It's probably definitely wrong, but I don't know much about Zelda, so don't hate on me too much if this is a really stupid answer.
This
okay?
was the only Zelda game I really played, like, all the way, besides Wind Waker, so...
As he sent it in first, he was right.
Am I right, then?
Robbie.
Yay!
Oh. And Soul got it right.
Oh, don't read mine!
Oh, no. Who do you say?
It's not a bad answer, though. He said Impa.
Oh.
Oh, okay.
It's not a bad answer if you think about...
You're the only person who's games. Upset about this. No one else is like, oh, or, like, it's fine, who cares?
Yeah, it's not. It's
isn't
not a doesn't
bad isn't she with Zelda or is she was like a Sheik or
Impa's
like,
not
I
in that
know.
Game.
Oh, okay, well then I'm okay. Never mind.
But it's not a bad answer if you would think about it. If you didn't know Zelda, it's not a bad answer.
Okay. Thank you.
So he sent it in first. It was like he knew it instantly, and Slow got it right.
For a second, I thought it was Rob Bio, but Yeah.
I put as a hint, don't say bunny. So I was giving a point if you said bunny. I was not. So I think that was Soul.
Yeah, that was me.
Honey Bunches.
So do we have one more Pokemon or is that gone?
It's the last Pokemon.
Oh. All right, let's do Pokemon.
Yeah.
Oh, boy.
All right.
Let me make sure. Oh, God. Let me make sure I get this right. I hope someone get this right here because I don't feel like the answer I have is right. Before Gen 5, this move curse was this type move. Oh, sorry. Let me read that over. Oh, never
no,
mind.
No, you're right.
Read it over.
You're right.
Before Gen 5, the move curse was this type move.
I needed to add one more of those, but it's, you know what I meant.
Oh my God, abbreviations again. I'm gonna kill myself.
Although Honey Bunch just sent it in
damn
first.
Oh, okay, never mind. Yes.
He sent it in first, actually.
Ugh, you're trash. I hate you.
Oh, Ezzy, I love you.
But Ezzy,
just,
you be,
just read
you
mine.
Be
get
mad.
It over with.
But you won't be mad at this answer. It was not the answer's not TM03. That was my hint. But it's actually ... type. It's three question marks.
Also known as like unknown
literally
or mystery type, stuff like that.
Yes. Honey Bunch just sent it in first. He had the correct number of question marks.
Ooh. Oh. Ooh.
Soul had two. Ezzy said special.
I
that's said, not bad.
I would have said it. I would have lost the point. Because I would answer. I would not answer.
Well, if you
I
just
did,
if you just wanted to see
answer
like a type that no one cares about, you could just say the Yoshi Man type.
Oh my, stop!
Oh. Very true. Very
no, very true. Don't.
All right. Okay, should I say the points again? Because we just finished another round. I should say the points.
Yes,
yeah,
please.
Sure.
Soul in first with 16, Honey Bunches in second with 13, and Ezzy in third with 12.
Oh, okay, it's close. It's close.
Yes. Very, very close. So, Ezzy,
for me, I'll do the anagram.
Yes. Ooh, this is my good one.
Oh, I'm gonna kill myself.
Oh, and there's no more Pokemon, by the way.
Okay.
Okay. Oh my God, y'all gonna laugh at me when I read
this. It's fine.
This.
It's fine.
Ooh, ha.
I spelled it.
I'm not done with it yet. Though.
Okay, fine.
I'm not done with it yet.
That's
all
it.
Those
or more?
Oh, no, there's more. It was
you
just
don't tell
like,
me to
get
shoot
it.
What's the hint? What's the hint?
Hoo ha! Although this is more of a boo ha.
Oh,
Luigi would not like this ghostly joke. Obi-Kong is your anagram.
Wait, say it again. Ruby. I didn't hear a word you said.
Hoo ha! Although this is more of a boo, ha.
Oh.
Luigi will not like this ghostly joke.
You tried to throw us off.
I got it.
And the anagram is Obi-Kong.
Did you know I was rushing for Donkey Kong when you said hoo, ha?
Yeah.
Like, my instinct was like, donkey.
Wait, so
Ezzy,
question.
I corrected myself.
So when you have the anagram and it says Kong at the end, can the K-O-N-G be mixed with the O-B-I?
Yeah, all the letters can be moved around.
Yes.
That's how anagrams work, Ezzy.
Okay, can you repeat it one more time? I was thinking about Donkey Kong for so long.
Hoo-ha! Although this is more of a boo-ha, Luigi would not like this ghostly joke.
Wow, I know the answer. Oh, I'm
took you long enough.
Oh my God. Everyone got it right. But let me see something, because...
I know I got this one right first.
16. Oh my God, you're kidding me. Oh my God, you're kidding me.
What?
Honey Bunch just sent it in first.
What?
Oh, yes.
Wait, how is that possible? I thought Sol knew it.
I like figured it out way before him. I'm calling fluke.
I don't know if this time in the off, I felt like Sol sent it first.
That's a fluke. I definitely sent it in first. I was.
It doesn't matter. I sent it in first.
Boo.
I typed first.
Ooh.
This is rigged.
Hey, if the abbreviations count, then I don't care. That freaking thing I typed could be abbreviated to King Boo, because abbreviations
no,
count.
No.
I don't care.
I don't care.
I
don't understand.
I said King Boo.
It is King Boo. Everyone got it right. I don't understand. I thought it was Soul.
I figured it
but
out.
But the timestamp... The timestamp says...
Suck it up, Soul.
It says 3:16:06 for Honey Bunches, but for Soul it said 316.09.
Fine, whatever.
Wow.
Two hoo-has for me.
I really felt like Soul said the first one, okay. We had the hoo-ha. Yeah, Luigi Dark Moon, King Boo.
I was gonna say Boo lost this, but then you showed me the anagram, and I was like, oh, never mind.
Okay.
It's for both games, Luigi Mansion and the Dark Moon. Everyone got it
SZ.
Right.
What's up?
Are you ready?
Four.
It's your turn.
What?
Wait, no, it's not SZ's turn. I think SZ just asked for the
Oh, dang it.
It's your turn.
Fine. It's your turn. You know what? As revenge, do the last anagram.
Well, we have two more anagrams.
We have two more. Fine. We have two more. Whatever. Just choose the next anagram. I'll do the next anagram.
Okay. This is two words. It's two words.
Two words.
Oh, Lord. This, when I read the hint, it's probably going to give away an answer before anything. Who's doing graffiti along the harbor? This ink monster is to blame. Glob or pee poor is the anagram. Glob or pee poor is the anagram, SZ.
I'm changing that because I realized when I saw
Yeah, I was going to say someone else as well.
All right, I'm going to send it in, but I think I'm wrong.
Everyone got it right.
Yay.
I got it right too?
Yes, Goopa Blooper.
Oh.
Rico Harbor.
I was going to say Glooper. Never mind. Oh, never mind. Just stop.
Actually, I started, Goopa I Blooper. Put an L there first.
Did I get it right first?
Goopa. Yes,
thank
you.
Did. Revenge right. from the last one.
Oh, you know what?
You
can choke out a big banana.
So, everyone got it right. So, it ain't not that hard. Thank you.
Thank you.
Super Mario Sunshine. And Honey Bunches, your turn.
All right, do we have any more for item shop or the shopping?
Oh, yes, we have three more.
Three more? Okay, let's do shopping.
Okay, I think this one's probably the hardest one because it's one game that nobody keep track of prices. Mario Party DS.
I knew it. Oh, no.
Three items. Triple dice set, halfway dice block, and snack bag.
Wait, say it again. I didn't hear what you said because I heard kids outside and I was just focusing on that.
Triple dice set, halfway dice block, and snack bag.
This is just guessing. It's shot in the dark.
Halfway? What the hell is a halfway?
Halfway dice block. I mean,
oh, God, I'm probably
It lets you roll 1 to 5.
They have
triple.
That in that game?
Oh, I'm probably wrong. Yes.
But it's not slow. It's not like the slow candy in Mario Party 8. It make you roll 1 to 5 in the dice block and just a normal dice block.
Oh, I think I got it wrong. I sent him in, though. Damn it.
Ooh! One of y'all got it right?
Ooh, who was it?
Oh, man, I don't think it was me.
Swear to God, it's me.
Oh, it was not. It's so. It was
thank
not
God.
East at 30.
Thank God. Isaac, okay. I swear to God.
It's between Honey Bunches 16 or SZ 18.
Oh, which no. Is it? Is it 18?
It's 16.
No. Yes!
No!
It's 16.
This
it's
how wait, so. Game with its $3 items or its three. Like
triples,
four
like
coins,
I think.
Six
triple,
coins.
I know, is 7. Mm-hmm. The halfway, I wasn't sure if it was like 2 or 3, so I thought maybe 1. Maybe 1, 2, 3. So I guess 1, and then the snack bag, I know, is 8. So like I knew. I played Mario Party DS recently, so ha.
Dang it.
Halfway dice block is 1.
So how many coins do I get?
Definitely 1 coin. Soul sent in 30 first.
No, sent in first, so I get 1 point.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Yes.
That was very, very close. That was very close. I'm like, oh, somebody got it right.
Oh, my goodness. This was not a good round for me. What's the updated score?
Okay. The scores. Soul in first with 19. Honey Bunches got 17. SZ got 14.
Dang. Okay, let's go for some Zelda.
Okay.
Is this the last one?
The one, the one category Ezzy might get.
Okay, I'm just going to tell you how the song is composed with the, this is going to give you a hint. This song is played with the Wind Waker.
Okay.
Point, and you got to use the control stick, you're on point right. So there's actually six C-stick commands. Up, up, down, right, left, right.
I have no damn clue.
I think Ezzy gets the bonus. The one that made the wind blow up. No, that's Ashley 3.
Oh.
So, Ashley 3. Hey, I can't. It's Ashley 3. Oh, this is so... Talk about children. Oh, this is so bad because... Let me see.
I said five answers.
Because I broke this down into a point scheme because... No...
You know, I'll take them all. I'll take it for the team. I'll take it all for my team.
Shut up, Essie. Because
I gave a full 3 points if you got the full name. And I gave 2 points if you got part of the name and 1 point if you got one part.
What's the name?
Wayne God's Aria.
What did he say?
He said Wayne's God Aria. He got the full points.
Oh. So how many points does he get? Name.
Three?
Only three.
Oh, my God.
He gets three. So he said win. He said win. But he said the wrong song. He said blow the opposite way.
Oh, so he shouldn't get all of it.
No, I don't get any points for that.
You don't get anything.
I refuse to take points for that.
But yeah. I broke down the points just in case someone said win God or just say a God song because I think there's two God songs. So
that's interesting. I replayed it like last week. I finished the game and I was at the Wind Temple. Oh, that's so funny.
So, SD picked a category just for him then, because he only one got it right. Honey Bunches, he said, Song of East, SD's stomach, Soul Track, man.
Wait, keep going.
Yoshi Man's in the head!
Song of Boost Children, come on.
It's Song of Boost Children! I can't! Oh lord, let me get it together. I think it's.
No, that was a song right now.
I think it's, Soul's turn.
Yeah, it's my turn. I don't want to go shopping. Let's do the Nintendo headquarters.
Ooh. Okay, let me. Yeah, at this point, this one, it has, what is it called? Extra points because the answer is actually that strict.
Why didn't Pokemon have extra points?
Oh, because the questions are not that strict.
Oh, okay.
But this one, let me just actually read the point distribution before I even get to it. I have actually five here. You get 3 points for exact year and 2 points within decade. You don't get 1 point for century. It's just actually 3-1. Let me change it. 3-1. 3 points for Zakia. 1 point if you're within the decade.
Okay.
And you also get the bonus if you send it in first. Okay. Be careful and let me read this question full.
Okay.
What year was the Nintendo company found? The card company. The Nintendo card company.
Oh, God.
I don't know.
I only know, like, the century.
Impossible. Okay.
Oh no, I think I'm way off.
Was if that I impossible was... to me?
Yes.
Did Essie get all of it right? I swear to God.
He got the exact year.
What
he
year?
Bye.
1889.
19 what?
1889. Oh, so if I was to add a decade, it would be from 1879 to 1809.
I said,
no, 1889. Oh my god, 1899.
I said the 1840s, so that was wrong.
I said,
and he got it right.
Damn it.
I don't know how, but he got it right.
You know what? I went with my gut feeling on this one. I was just like, I think this is it. Like, I've seen it before. Also, I think in Animal Crossing, one of the animals wears a t-shirt with this year on it for this reason. So I think that might have helped too.
That's
how many points does this person right here get?
It was 3 again.
Oh my god, I'm in last place.
Was I first?
Let me see where you. Oh, if you were first, okay, good. 370. Oh my god.
What?
Wait, no, Honey Bunches was first.
Dang it.
Good.
Honey Bunches said 1913, Soul said 1840s. Oh, aww. Boy. I don't know how, but he got it right. So, Honey Bunches.
All right, we're going to do shopping. And shopping better have, like, a three-point thing. Because every category everyone else is picking has, like 3 points. I want a three-point thing for item shopping.
This track, Mario Party 2.
Uh-oh.
There's only two items, which is weird. Dueling Love and Magic Lamp.
I think I actually know this one. Wait, I didn't mean to type that.
Oh.
Honey Bunches sent it in first.
Oh, wait. Oh, no, wait. It's actually... Oh, I don't know. Oh, can I change my answer? I'm not sure. I think it's the second one.
If you,
I don't care. I don't care. I want the second one.
If you change your answer, you're not the first to send in that change answer.
That's fine,
because
I don't think it's 20. That's Mario Party 4, I think. I don't know. I think it's the second one, though.
Okay, so let me copy to see the timestamp for this one.
I don't care if I'm not first, but I really think it's the second one, though. I'm not sure.
The answer's 45.
Oh, my God.
Okay.
I gotta compare. No, as he sent it in first.
That's fine.
If I take to change the answers. Dueling Glove 15, Magic Lamp is 30.
Okay.
I was having the same battle. I'm like, is it 15 or 20?
Dang it.
15 or 20. Yeah, Soul said
40. This is not cool.
Soul said 40. I can't take those kids outside no more if you want to know. Oh, boy.
Oh, I posted in the chat. Whoops. My bad. Dark Boo.
And that's,
That's it for this round? Okay, because the previous round, yes, really bad. This round was really good to me.
So. Yes, it is. Aziz is first.
21. We need to get it.
Soul 19, Honey Bunches 18.
Sorry, we need to turn this around.
If he gets lucky with like 3 points again.
This is unprecedented that Ezzy is ever in the lead on any
Every
quiz.
Single oh, right. one Ezzy's picking is three points. That's ridiculous.
No, this is
Pokemon should have added 3 points.
Unprecedented. We need to change this. Is it whose turn is it?
Ezzy.
Stop making that noise.
If Zelda Historia gets another 3 points, that's ridiculous, just saying.
What's the category with the least picked?
They all got one question left.
Oh, okay. We will do let's just get the anagram over with.
Yes.
Anagram?
This is what I'm good at. Yeah.
Oh, boy. Okay. Let me copy and paste this before I go. Okay. Ooh. So, don't take offense. He is the embodiment of it in 3D. So, luckily he doesn't live with snakes.
Excuse me.
Are we going to say the anagram?
Stoic trash.
What the heck?
Wait, can you say it again? Say the anagram again.
He's the embodiment of it in 3D. So, luckily he doesn't live with snakes.
Oh my goodness, what is this? What is this?
I don't know this one.
If I read it again and emphasize some words for him, he's the embodiment of it in 3D. So, lucky he doesn't live with snakes.
I can't think of any levels like that.
So the hint is 3D and snakes.
Yeah, I'm thinking of games in 3D and snakes. Or without snakes.
Like, you know what? I think you're trying to be tricky with 3D here. And I think I know what game you're talking about, but...
doesn't live with snakes.
Ooh, oh! How much time do we have left?
Oh no.
They're going to be time limit when someone sent in something.
I don't know this one.
I don't know. I'm still thinking about this. We need another hint.
It's 3D.
Yeah, do you have another hint?
Oh, the hint is 3D and snakes.
No.
Is it only for Mario games?
Yeah, it's a Mario game.
It's for Mario game.
Okay.
Can you tell us what console this game was on? How about that?
3D. It'll sound like a 3DS.
Oh, 3DS, what?
Let me make sure. Oh my god. It's so bad.
I'm so nervous. What is this?
I'm gonna Oh, it's not 3DS, it's Wii U, sorry.
Oh, Wii U.
Yes.
Oh my god, this is a good one. I don't know.
I have, like, a feeling, like, a general feeling.
I need a bigger hint, boo, because I literally have no clue. I literally, I promise you right now, I have zero clue right now.
Oh, I don't remember the Mario Party 10 bosses.
The 3D is not meaning 3D. It means the name of the game.
Okay. Good, good.
Oh my god.
Literally, I can't figure this out. This isn't kind of bad.
And like I said, snakes is the other hint.
What's his name?
Why can't I even remember the game?
Is it a two word? Is it a two word?
No, it's one word.
One word combined.
It's one word. So you gotta take all the letters and make one word.
Oh my god, why can't I think of the game? I hate myself. Wait, Wii U, 3.
Yes, I think I got it. I think.
As he sent it at first. So only a few more minutes.
Minutes? Oh my god.
Okay. 3.
Give me minutes.
3D. 3D. Okay.
Holy bunches.
I'm thinking.
The suspense is killing me. I wanna know if I got it right or not.
I'm gonna kill myself when I realize that this is so easy.
That was a hard one.
Oh!
Yeah, see, it's coming to you.
I know what it is now. What is it?
Honey,
I'm gonna send it in, but I think I'm wrong on this. I'll make sure I spell it.
I know the theme.
I'm probably wrong. This is probably wrong, but that's the only one I can think of.
Oh.
I can't think of the name. Okay.
Oh no.
I'm probably wrong.
He didn't get the name. The hint was 3D, meaning Super Mario 3D World.
Yeah, it took me forever. I thought it was like a game with like DDD. Like it started like that. I was really confused. Oh. And I was overthinking
it's snakes. It's actually the boss. It's actually telling you what the boss is. Yeah. It's a snake.
Okay. What?
Am I right? Is it right?
Histocrat.
That was the name.
Yes. As Z sent it in first, followed by Honey Bunches.
Oh, when it hit me, I was like, "Oh, there it is!" I couldn't figure out the name for a few seconds though.
That was the last anagram boss battle question too. That was hard.
Well, congratulations, SC, you win.
No,
okay. Congratulations to wait. They're not done yet.
You have how many points does SC have?
So far, he has 23.
Okay, yeah, you win. There's no chance of us winning now.
Yeah, this has happened before. Don't worry.
So, your turn.
Okay, choose the... I think it's the only other one left is the Nintendo HQ one.
Okay. This one is Redemption.
Come on.
Let me make sure I'm typing in Dark Boom. Okay, got it.
Okay, this Redemption time. What was the first handheld game Nintendo launched?
Ooh, I mean...
I don't care. Soul, please. I don't care. I sent it in.
Okay.
I don't care.
Okay. I think I know this one. I think.
Well, you know what I meant, right? You know what I meant.
Yeah, and you get the extra points for it, too.
Play, praise God. God.
Wait, extra points? So I don't think I got that one right, then.
Yeah, I didn't either.
He gets the extra points for it.
I'm trying to think back.
Everyone sent it in. Okay. I gave 2 points if you said Game & Watch.
Oh, what? Damn, oh,
yep. There we go. There was something else.
There's a caveat.
And I gave 3 points if you said Game & Watch Ball. If you said the actual game Ball.
Oh, so I get 2 points, right?
Yeah, and you get the actual point for sending it in first.
22?
Yes. Only Honey Bunches got it right. As Z said Game Boy and Soul said Nintendo.
I thought we were... Why did I think DS?
It was the first game that was launched. Game & Watch Ball. Okay, so that only leaves Honey Bunches. You have a choice between We're Going Shopping or Zelda Historia.
What do you wait? So that means that one will not be chosen, or will both still be chosen?
Ooh, my pizza here.
Oh, one will be the last one.
Oh. Okay, we're gonna do shopping.
Okay, Mario Party 4.
God, I'm just gonna. Okay, I admit defeat. I'll tell you this now.
There's three items. Three items: mini mushroom, Bowser suit, and SWAT card.
Did I send it in first?
Yes.
Dang it.
Okay.
I was just guessing.
And I only. And I think only Honey Bunch is gonna get it right.
Wait.
That's telling.
Whoa. Wait, hold on. I'm thinking about the what's it called? The Bowser suit. You mean the Bowser mushroom?
Oh yeah, the Bowser mushroom.
Oh yeah, that's what I was thinking. Like, what is he talking about Bowser suit? But I never see anyone get it. Oh, I don't even think you can buy the Bowser suit. Shh. Why am I saying that out loud?
I already sent it in.
I'm not taking it.
Okay. I'm probably gonna get this wrong because, but I. There we go.
You did fall for the trick. Everyone else did. Honey Bunch just got it right.
What? What was it?
Bowser suit costs nothing in the game. You get it for free from Bowser.
Dang it.
And so y'all put 50.
We both put 50?
And ZSO put 50.
But they sent it at first.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. So at least get
they
one
point. put 50 immediately. Y'all thought it was 30 coins? Because Mini Mushroom is 5, Swap Card is 15. So that's 20.
Yes.
Oh, wow, that's it?
Yeah, Bowser suit is nothing. You get it from Bowser free, okay. Which is rare.
Judge me all you want.
Can we do a score update before the last question?
Wasn't that the last question?
No, there's one more question, and God knows.
Wait, what is that?
Oh, Zelda.
It's a Zelda. No! It's the Zelda one. And we eat. We need someone to get this right because SZ and Honey Bunch is a tie with 23.
Congratulations, SZ.
So has 19.
No, I'm scared. Oh. I'm really scared.
You're gonna don't be scared. Questions. I don't know anything about Zelda. You know. Oh.
Oh boy. It's come down to this question.
I feel like Boo did when like me and Boo were in that quiz and then it was like that last Pokemon question and we both knew it. Oh, I don't know Zelda though.
Oh my goodness. And it's actually challenging. It's a cutscene.
Oh, this is the one.
So, good luck with this question. It's the last one. Whew. In Arbiter Grounds, where Ganon was punished, he ended up killing a sage. This sage was the sage of... Yeah, tell me the sage.
Oh. Mm-hmm. Like that? I mean, what? I can't. I don't know how many questions I'm allowed to send. Answers.
Oh my goodness.
They have names?
No. You actually have it right. But it's now depending on who sent it in first. Because both of y'all have it right. But one of y'all sent it in first.
Well, I have it right?
Yes.
Do I have it right?
Soul has it wrong. He picked time.
Oh, dang it.
It's water. Now, it depends on which one he has sent it in first.
Oh, no.
Oh, I'm sorry for what I'm sorry.
Oh, SZ got it first.
SZ sent it in first.
Oh. Why would he apologize to you, SZ? You're winning.
No. SZ sent it in
What's
first.
What's the answer? What's the answer, please?
It was Sage of Water.
Oh, well.
SZ sent it in. When I finished the question, SZ sent it in immediately. Well,
I knew it.
GG. Exactly.
And that was a cutscene.
Congratulations, SZ.
Thank you. I don't know if I've ever won before.
Literally, I can't believe this is unprecedented. SZ got above second to last and won.
Oh, goodness. The final score.
Those Zelda ones saved my life. But yeah, also, on the flip side, the Pokemons killed me.
I wish they murdered
me. SZ won with 25. That was very, very, very close.
How many did I have?
24.
Oh, boy.
Just take a knife and stab me. Oh, my God.
24. Soul had 19. Soul was in the lead for the longest. Yeah. What happened?
Those, literally, the Zelda ones... And the shopping ones, because I don't know Mario Party scores, and I don't know Zelda at all.
Oh, man, because Soul was... Like, he was dead in the lead. It was like no redemption because I had like 2 or 4 and so I had over 11. And then, as you know, it just totally shifted. Oh boy, that was the last question.
That's the end of Dark Boo Gets Quizzy with it.
Yes, it was. I hope the categories were not hard.
No, they the only one that was hard for me was the shopping one, but
Zelda was the only one that pissed me off. Next time, Pokemon. Don't include Zelda.
Yeah, and don't include Pokemon.
I noticed every single quiz
we do has Pokemon.
Because Pokemon's huge.
Even the one I did. Dang it.
Hey, but Pokemon, hey, real quick. True tea. Zelda only you know, though. Pokemon, me, and Soul.
Well, I know
so
a little
it's
bit
not
of Zelda.
Like, it's just for one person. It's not for just one person. Well, for Zelda, that's just you.
But that's not fair, just because saying. When I made a quiz, it was made for you, Ezzy, and Boo. And Ezzy and Boo know Zelda.
Yet we lost.
And then when Boo's a participant, Boo doesn't know Pokemon.
Yeah.
So he's with me.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know Pokemon. Think it.
I don't think there's a way to be fair unless you do just Mario quiz.
Okay, but if it was Mario Party
Prices.
Donkey
Kong quiz.
Okay, but if it was Mario Party Prices like it was now, would not be fair to me, but that's just because I don't pay attention to that sort of thing.
Well, it's a Mario Party podcast.
You know, stop judging me.
Yeah, I had to be fancy with these categories because I didn't want it to be really, really general. So even with the anagram boss battle, yeah, I flew through it, and I thought it was gonna be the hardest of all because I had to make sure everything made sense.
It was fun.
Except the last one, Histocrat. Histocrat was just—it was a slap in your. It wasn't hard. It just was a slap in your face when you realized what the answer was.
Well, good games, good games.
Yeah,
good job, SC. At least I didn't get slaughtered, so I'm happy.
What did I do? Why are you doing this?
I didn't say you get slaughtered. I at least didn't get slaughtered. If it was like 10 points behind, I would have been like, oh my god, never joining a quiz again.
Just note, you didn't get a boo score. You did not get a dark boo score. Because if you would have got a dark boo score, that would have been detrimental. That would have been sad, actually. Because knowing me, if you would have gave me these questions, what? Only point I would have probably got right is the shopping. Because it's numbers. That's the only thing I can remember. But I can't remember a year 1889. I still to this day don't know how SC got that right. Still to this day. I thought that was the most ubiquitous question.
If I was cheating and looking it up,
I could just type Nintendo into Google search and it's right there, 1889. Literally
okay,
right there.
If
you just type Nintendo.
I didn't do it. FYI.
But that's the end of that quiz of the nightmare. It was only 25 questions. Oh, I hope y'all enjoyed it.
No, it was fine. I liked it.
Yeah, it was fun.
And I don't say because I want the questions to stay in there so one can just rebound on them. And therefore, we have the news. Nintendo. Any Nintendo news today?
Just more Pokemon stuff.
I know there's a lot of Mario Party. Star Rush. A lot of videos. I know from Japan, right?
Yeah,
of videos.
Mm-hmm.
Go ahead.
I was just gonna say that it was from they put up their official website for Japan for Star Rush, and whenever that happens, they always have tons of screens and videos. And so we have on Mario Party Legacy, we have like 14 minutes of footage from there, 13 probably, and this game looks fun. Like this
it
game
looks
is,
fun.
I'm so ready for it. I mean, yes, let's get it out of the way. No online. It's so disappointing, and it really sucks. But looking past that, this is still looking like one of the best Mario Party games in the longest time.
I'm sorry. It does. When I looked at Mario Party 10, I was not excited. Because, first and foremost, it felt like Mario Party 9 2.0. But this game feels... The coin marathons. That looks fun. The other one where it's like you had to pop the you had to get the star balloon.
Yeah, yeah.
That looks fun.
Yes.
The mini games are everything looks fun, and especially the boss battle with all the characters. I love it. And you can see them all. First of all, they wasn't even fighting Petey Piranha. They were fighting each other. Let me put that up there. They were fighting each other. So I know if I'm able to play it, God willing, if I'm able to play it, I know I'm going to get mad at the computers. You ain't going to throw no shell at me so I can get hurt.
Who's going to throw a 3DS across the room?
Yes, I am. I will throw a 3DS.
By the way, we recently did a podcast about Mario Party Star Rush, podcast 231, hosted by Dark Boo.
Yeah.
Yes, we did. I'm sorry, this game is fun. It looks so, I was happy when I was watching it. I don't know why, but I was happy. It looks so fun. Although there's not online, but if you don't even know it's the online, because the thing is, when you watch it, the first thing that's on your mind is not online until the end of the video, where you're like, it hits you. There's no online for this game.
Yeah.
But it looks fun. And there's one mini game where they run up the, it's like a spiral, it's like a spiral staircase. That reminds me of I know it was on Xbox. I mean, I think when you put in the Halo game, and there's like a little, there's another thing on it. I know for a fact, because I remember it. And it was a game just like that. It was like a little mini game thing, but I forgot what game it was for. Only thing I know is a special feature for Halo.
Interesting.
Yes, it was a special feature, and it's the same exact mini game. It looks the same. It's just different. Oh my goodness!
All of them look really nice and creative. Like they look fun, and they just visually look so good. Yeah.
The puzzle one where they had to build the bridge.
It's very impressive.
I think that one is fun because it's more time. Like you're rushing to get the pieces rather than actually have to sit there and plan.
Oh yes. Have you guys seen the Wiggler one?
Yes, I did.
Where you ram into each other in the Wiggler cart?
Yes.
People go flying into the wall, the invisible wall.
I love it.
In the video, if you go on Mario Party Legacy's YouTube channel and you look at the latest Mario Party Star Rush video for the Japanese website videos, it starts off with that piranha plant minigame where you're shooting the piranha plants, the golden ones, the normal ones, mm-hmm. and everyone's on all four sides. Donkey Kong makes this noise. He's like, go check it out. It's like that. But yeah, go check that out. But speaking of games that are looking a lot better as we get closer to release date, Paper Mario Color Splash, the Japanese website videos for that, it looks like such a good game. Like, I know we have problems with the battle, and there's no unique characters, and the story's kind of...
Okay, stop. You're making the game sound terrible.
Are so, like, the how it looks, just the creative aspect to how the paper theme works, everything looks just so good. Am I the only one?
I'm gonna get the game.
I have to look at everything else aside. It is aesthetically pleasing. And there's one video, I know it's not a recent one, the Coliseum one. I died in laughter when Mario got the star and the announcer said he cheated his way through.
Yeah, that was great.
I died in laughter. But all about Albia, I don't. The battle. I'm sorry. I'm still the. Yeah. I'm still the 1,000-year door type of person. But if I look at it aside, I don't like the battle, and they even showed it in the video. I don't. Oh my god. But other than that, I don't have no problems with it so far. Although the NPCs are another story.
Yeah, what I'm thinking is if for this game, if you're a big Paper Mario fan, at least like me, oh my gosh, I love Thousand Year Door. But if I keep looking at it that way, I'm just gonna judge the game negatively. So I'm gonna try not to think about it too much as a Paper Mario game, and just think about it as a Paper Mario spinoff or something like that. Because if I keep thinking about it that way, I know I'm just gonna play the game and I'll be so negative about it. So I'm trying not to think about that so much. I'm trying to focus on positive things, like, you know, aesthetically, it looks even more beautiful than Sticker Star. So, you know, everything looks juicy, painting everything. You know, all the stickers and the stickers, things. You know. Yeah, the things. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Okay, let me talk about this. I love there's also, like, this one thing where, like, it's like an orange. And then, like, the orange just, like, squirts juice into your opponents. I love it.
I think it's a lemon.
I need to use it.
Yeah, I like the pig.
It's an orange or mandarin or something like that. A pig? What?
The breakdancing.
The pig. Oh, my God. Dying! I love it.
It's really funny. It's just, I still don't feel like I'm going to buy the game.
What's the creature that spins over? The chain chop, like, spins over the enemies. You just see the chain chop slowly rolling and just squashes them.
I was dying, especially with the fan. The pig one just had me. It had me right then with the fan. I was like, Yes, yes, yes. The pig, when it was breakdancing, I cried in laughter. I cried. I was like, no, no. I know you didn't have a pig doing that. And the fan even had me. The fan, it was always funny. The fan was always funny, but they had it even worse. That did just fly to the screen. But those little things are funny. Those the funny part of the game. Mm-hmm. And it's very creative. Like I said, the pig. It's very, very creative. I would have never thought of a pig. I thought they was going to crack the piggy bank at first. But instead, they had the pig dancing. So it's just innovation at its finest.
One thing that I also noticed is that, because I know recently there's like been that whole talk about how the Mario Luigi series and the Paper Mario series are kind of like the idea that there's two RPGs and they need to make one kind of different from the other. But one thing that's been made very clear with these recent videos is that the humor in Paper Mario is very different from the humor in Mario and Luigi. I can't explain it, and I don't know how to pinpoint it, but you can tell. You can tell that it's very different humor-wise. Just the way characters talk and how they interact, it's very specific to this series. So I'm very happy that that has not been removed. That's still there. Even if the characters are mostly toads and whatever, that has not been removed. But
I need a big break from paper toads.
Yeah, I agree. The big plus is that, and it's sad that I have to say this, but like characters like Bowser and the Koopalings, they talk. They're not mute. They talk. And they talk like they would in the old Paper Mario games. Maybe not the Koopalings, but Bowser. And you can talk to enemies too. Like there's in the Colosseum, you talk to different enemies, and there's the Sniffits in some of the videos. Like that will be a part of Paper Mario still. So that's very good.
I hope so much that Sniffit or Whiffit returns. I love that.
Well, overall, I think we have a lot of hope for these games that are coming out.
And it's coming out quick. It's going to be out in like 3 weeks, I think. 3 weeks.
We have a lot of hope for these games. Because they are so far, they are serving us what we need. Except if you're biased about Paper Mario. Yes. If you're biased about it, then it's not going to serve you what you need. That's the thing. You can't be biased with that game. And that's like with any game. You can't be biased with it. Like, you can't be like, oh, this is the way this is, so I know this one going to be at ABC.
Especially for the most part. I mean, yeah. Like, for Metroid Prime Federation Force, people were pretty negative on that game when it first was announced, and some of that was justified because the end product was not the best. So, I mean, it depends, situation by situation. And we have a podcast on that, episode 230, I believe.
Ooh, yeah.
I think two more things are worth talking about for news. The fourth one will be Pokemon, and I'll let whoever take over for that.
Oh,
but
God.
The second one, I want to actually ask a question. Do you think the NX will be announced in September?
No.
No, because it is getting time. It is time for this thing to be announced already. We still don't have
anything official. No, it's not getting announced until the holiday season. They want, or probably October, maybe November. What they're trying to do is you want to create as much hype for Nintendo for the holiday season, so it's probably the next best thing since we know it's coming out in March. It'll be revealed around the holiday season, so not now.
Didn't they have a release date for the NX?
Yeah, March something.
Leak, yeah.
Yeah, I'm tired of things being leaked or rumored.
No, from what I remember, this was like credible. Like, yeah, we know it's coming out this because I think it was the Breath of the Wild release date got leaked, and we know that that is going to be released on the same day the NX is released. So,
I see that's a tough one. It's very likely that's the case, but you still have the fact that there's a Wii U version, and for whatever crazy reason, what if they released it early and that's not actually the NX release date? Not likely, but that's still a possibility. And I think it was for the Amiibo. Sorry. For Breath of the Wild. Not for the game itself.
Yeah, I don't think they would be released on different days. So, same day.
I agree. But actually, if they were going to release on separate days, it'd be the Wii U one later. So that people buy the NX to play Zelda.
I would be mad. Yeah. Let me put that out there, because I'm buying Breath of the Wild day one.
What? On Wii U, not NX.
The Wii U, not the NX. I'm buying it day one. When it comes out day one, I'm getting it. I may have to go to GameStop in Roosevelt Field because you know the one in Hempstead, I threatened it, so I may not be able to go there.
Roll some heads. Oh my gosh.
It's true, yeah. I said I'm gonna blow up the store.
Oh my god, Boone, it's a threat! You can't do that!
Without getting arrested.
I made myself sound like Saddam Hussein.
Oh my god.
Oh my god, okay, enough.
I did.
Okay, last thing is Pokemon, and I don't know what else to... I don't know what to say on Pokemon. I know the Generations thing, and then some new Pokemon, I think.
So. Yeah, I don't know a thing about Pokemon as well. I haven't even seen the Pokemon news, actually. It's, I only saw...
All they did was reveal, okay, Rockruff's evolution has two different evolutions depending on when it evolves. It'll go into the midday form if it is in the day, and then it'll go into the midnight form in the night. And the midnight one kind of looks like a werewolf one, and then the midday one just looks like a cool wolf. I like the midday one better. What else? Oh, and then they revealed two new Ultra Beasts, and it seems like they'll have the same number, but they're not the same Ultra Beast. The first is Ultra Beast Absorption, and you run into it in Pokemon Sun, and it's a giant muscular mosquito. And then the other one is... UB02, oh, by the way, it's UB02 Absorption. I'm not sure if I said that first part. Anyway, yeah, UB02 Beauty, and it's like this queen, it looks like Queen Vexus from My Life as a Teenage Robot, if any of the listeners know what that is. She looks exactly like it.
I know what that
is. Yeah, she looks exactly like her. She was voiced by, I think she was voiced by the same person who voiced, Number 5 from Kids Next Doors. Anyway, so yeah, that's a thing, and she's like some weird beauty insect thing, and they face off against Tapu Koko in their respective versions, Beauty and Moon, Absorption and Sun. Again, we don't know exactly what the heck these things are, like, if they're catchable, most likely they are, if they are technically Pokemon, and if they have typing, or why they are a threat to the Alola region. These two look like they're more of a threat because they're attacking Tapu Koko. The first one is a jellyfish-looking thing that looks like one of our friends in the game. I put friends in quotation marks because who the heck. That was honestly it. All we know is Korokoro, there's gonna be like revelation on what the heck type null's deal is, like why it's has a mask and what it has this what this power it holds is. That's basically what it's saying. That'll be next month. I'm assuming we already got the revelations of the Ultra Beasts in America, but we did not get the wolves, the evolutions for Rockruffs in America. So what I'm assuming is there's probably going to be more Pokemon news this month, I think. Because usually that's what happened. The only exception is when they announced Nekoala and Rockruff originally, they announced it like 2 months before it was announced in America, so... That's all.
And Pokemon Generations.
So they announced this weird web series, and they're basically like, hey, Pokemon Generations. And we're like, what is that? It's basically a web series of videos that are like taking place throughout all the generations in the games. And the first two were released on the channel already, the Pokemon channel. And the first one is just like an overview of the five regions, and I think, or the six. Six regions, not counting Alola. They're not covering Alola. So I think that's cool. And then the other one was... it was this one starring Looker. You know Looker. The dude from the International Police. And he was heading this stakeout mission against Team Rocket.
Okay. So go check it out. I think it's also on Pokemon's YouTube channel. So you can check it out there.
So, yeah, that's all the news.
I didn't know they had a YouTube channel. So bad. I hope I'm not the only one.
You probably are.
Oh, that's sad. So, that's all the news?
Yes, I believe so.
Yeah, I think so.
What have we been doing? What is up next? Who wants to go first?
I will go first.
Go ahead.
All right, so because I don't have a lot, so let me just talk about this. I've been playing a lot of Smash Bros. Wii U lately, and I've been really pissed off lately. I've been getting mad as hell and things of that nature because I've been playing a lot of Jigglypuff, and Jigglypuff is terrible one-on-one. And I've been getting pissed as heck, pissed off so much. So I'm thinking maybe dropping Jigglypuff for a bit, and I'm going to be picking different characters. So I'm going to be picking up Mar... What's so funny about that?
Nothing.
Okay. I'm picking Marfa. I'm going to be using Sheik more, and I'm going to be thinking of picking Zero Suit Samus up. Yeah, my Zero Suit Samus can beat certain people's characters.
I forgot about canning. So let's not get hasty
on that. Yeah, but, yeah, what I'm basically trying to say is, because I made, like, Twitter rants recently about getting so pissed off
about, I've seen them.
About that crap, because literally, I'm picking Jigglypuff, and I make it all the way to the Grand Finals, and I lose to, like, a Cloud or a Ryu or Bayonetta, and every time they beat me, they like, taunt a bunch, and I'm just thinking, why the hell are you taunting, like, when Jigglypuff is a terrible character? Why would you taunt about beating a character who's flawed? Like, I don't get that. Like, okay, yeah, I beat you, in your face, whatever. But, like, I'm picking Jigglypuff. Unless you're playing as Little Mac, that's different. But, like, I'm picking Jigglypuff and you're bragging about beating Jigglypuff. If you brag about beating a Jigglypuff, then you're pathetic. Because Jigglypuff is a very, 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 very flawed character. And I don't care. Oh, well, the person's good, so it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter.
Salt.
Your Jigglypuff is still a flaw. Yeah, Salt. It's Salt and Pepper up in here.
But he easy to get out, though. It feels like Jigglypuff once, that's it.
Yeah, especially if you're picking, like, Bayonetta.
Exactly, yes.
And you're picking Bayonetta and you're bragging about being Jigglypuff. That is so pathetic. It's pathetic. And yes, I am salty right now if you can't tell. So that's why I'm picking Marfa. I'm picking Sheik up. I'm picking Zersu Samus. I might try to Bayonetta a little bit because Bayonetta is so damn cheap. I need to try to hone that power and show other people the cheapness.
Staryu.
Because what?
You need to, first of all, calm down. Secondly, I can't believe you would be a traitor and go to OP character Sheik.
I always have used Sheik since Brawl. So that's neither here nor there. And secondly, with Bayonetta, it's just because I'm getting so pissed. Because you know what I realize? You know how Timmy goes to like those weeklies and he goes to tourneys, right? And he talked about it. It's not like a secret or anything. I want to go to those things as well because I live in New York. There are tons of tourneys, tons of weeklies. I've been to a tourney once. It wasn't a big tourney. It wasn't like, oh, like 80, 100 people. Not like Apex or anything like that. But it was like a small thing. Like, you know, 80 people. And I made it pretty far in the tournament. But I realized more and more that characters like Jigglypuff are not gonna bring me far. Characters like Jigglypuff are just not cut out for one-on-one. I'm not saying four-player. I'm not saying three-player. I'm saying straight up one-on-one. And I can't deal with it. So I'm gonna be a tier trader. And I'm going to start using those overpowered characters. So next time you play Smash Bros. With me, which, by the way, you can, because I have a Nintendo Network, SpiderStaryu. You go send me an invite, say you watch the podcast or whatever, and I will play you and I will show you how I've been practicing with these characters. But other than that, that is it. Yeah, that's it.
Who wants to go next?
Me.
Go ahead.
Okay, so this week, did I mention it on the podcast? No, I mentioned it before the podcast. So, I don't know. I've had a weird week where I started to feel really sad, and I don't know why, and it's really getting on my case. But, no, I started feeling, like, not even, like, sad, but, like, down. Like, something was wrong. And the entire week up until Wednesday, I'm sitting here like, something's wrong, and I don't know what, and it's throwing everything off. And then I got over it on Wednesday, and then it came back. Something feels off. I don't know what exactly. I think it's nerves because, you know, with my special school stuff, it's always nerves. Like, I always have something to be nervous about. Like, after this, I literally am going to be doing pre-cal because I'm nervous and I need to go prepare. But other than that, I actually did some fun stuff because, was I on the last podcast? Last week's podcast? Yeah, I think it was. So I mentioned pretty much all I was doing, because it's pretty much just a continuation of that. However, what's something new I did? So let's think of something interesting. Oh, I went to, I was playing some more with Superstar Saga, and I'm having a lot of fun. I mean, not too much fun, you know, a healthy amount. I said I was probably not going to go back, but then I decided, you know what, I'm going to go back. And it's not bad. I'm kind of enjoying it. Unfortunately, I'm having a lot of trouble with the bosses. Like, pretty much each boss I've fought, I'm like, like, I have to do it, like, twice, three times, four times. Did I do it? No, not four times. But, you know, I was doing okay. Thankfully, I think I'm getting the hang of the action command timing, because I'm really, like, I used to be really good with timing, but lately I have been not so good at it. So yeah, that's, I mean, no, I don't usually talk about what I've been playing, especially as of lately, because I just haven't been playing too many video games, but I have been playing that, and it was very, very nice. That's all I've been doing.
I got, I think, three things to mention. The first one, a new theme for Mario Party Legacy is done. Well, it's not done, but it's up and running. You can go on MarioPartyLegacy.com and check that out. I've been working on that for the last couple of weeks. It's this new blue theme. The game pages for Mario Party are returning, or they're back. And the character pages are back, too. So lots of cool little things. And it's better for mobile. So when you're on your phone, it works a little bit better. Nice, cool, whatever. So go check that out. Also, there's a new logo. There's new, I guess, background details for Facebook, Twitter. Everything's gotten a fresh new look. So go check that out. After like 3.5 years. So, big deal. Second thing is that I did another live stream for Banjo-Kazooie this last Wednesday at noon. It was actually at like 40 minutes past noon because I was busy at the time. But I did that. I streamed for almost 2 hours.
Yes, I saw.
And it went pretty well. I had people there chatting with me, and some people shared Banjo-Kazooie music that they made, and I actually was able to model at the same time, and the model that I made actually came out, it turned out pretty well. So, I know. So go check that out. That's archived on my YouTube as well. And segue into, I wasn't going to live stream that Wednesday because I was packing up and moving. I moved out of my apartment that I've been in the last year, basically, since January. So I moved into a new place. I just got there last night, unpacked everything, and yeah, I got
so it. You're barely here, like, ready?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I haven't been here for a full 24 hours. I got my computer set up. I ran to Goodwill. Goodwill closes at 9, and I drove to Goodwill, and I picked up this nice, big wooden desk. I really like it, because that's how I want my desk. Nice, big, flat, and open. So I got this big old desk now, and I am in a new place. So if you hear new weird noises, that'll be because I'm in a new place. So, yeah, that's what I've been up to. I haven't really been playing games. Although I will say that last week, after the podcast, we played Mario Kart Custom Tracks for 5 hours straight. Me and Staryu, and then Boo joined towards the end. Wow. Yeah, a lot of shenanigans there. But, yeah, that's what I've been up to.
And for me, I haven't been playing games this week, no. Because what happened was, I have a job, Huntington Learning Center.
You got a new job. Woo.
Yes. So I'll be going out the house. They asked me what hours should I do, so I didn't say Saturday because of the podcast. Mm. I said Sunday instead.
Aw.
Yeah, I wasn't going on Saturday anyway, please. No offense. I'm not going on Saturday. So I got that job after I traveled so much, and wearing those shoes hurt your heels. Mm. I can't wear anything with heels. I don't see how women wear heels first and foremost. I can't even wear boots for a long time because my feet start cramping. I went from so many towns, Hempstead, Garden City, Car Place. Then I went from Car Place all the way to Merritt because I had to go to another interview, which was nothing. It was BS. No offense. That job was BS because the person who was interviewing me, he was so boring. He was like let me not say it, but he was boring. He was like, this is the job. He said more times than he even said a word. I'm like, oh, hell no. You ain't made me go out to no damn Merrick. I had to run from the mall. I had to run in the mall to catch the bus to get there. You know I was over it. Other than that, I have not been doing anything. No, I want to start editing my game, but because I got to actually do graphics over because we have a new... We have a new font, so I have to do the things over. Thank you. And that's... Honestly, that's pretty much it. I have not played a game. I've been watching, because I want to play Ace Attorney, but I can't play it, so I gotta watch it. I've been watching Ace Attorney: Spirit of Justice.
Ooh, I heard it's actually pretty good.
Yes, I can say that the first, not to spoil anything, but it's centered around one person and their history, because the game that they were introduced in, you didn't know that much of their history, but I don't like how they building more on the history, and the history don't make sense until, it's a back history of a history.
Now,
which I,
sorry, is this anime dubbed or subbed? Or both?
Oh, the anime different.
I know.
The anime is...
Why did I say this anime? I was asking, is the anime dubbed or subbed? Because I was wondering if this game is gonna... If the, you know, is involved with that.
Oh, the anime and the game, they're totally different.
Okay. Just wondering.
Sorry, what's the difference between dubbed and subbed?
Sorry, that was such a non-sequitur, but dubbed is when it's... People speak over in English. Subbed is just subtitles in English.
Mm-hmm. It's subtitles for the anime.
Cool, thank you.
Yeah. Definitely subtitles. And... I don't, the game, I can say so far, it have not been boring, although there's one case that is just sad. I mean, it'll make you cry.
Oh, no.
The reason why people go at great lengths, it'll make you cry.
How many?
The third case.
Sorry, how many cases are in there?
I think there's five, because usually it's normally
yeah,
five.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking.
And I think there's a DLC one as well.
Yes.
Except Apollo Justice. I think Apollo Justice is the only one with four.
The second game has four as well.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Wait.
And the first one originally had four until they added that.
Oh, yeah, the one on the DS. Right.
Mm-hmm.
But all I've been doing. What happened?
Really random note. Speaking of Ace Attorney, did you know they announced a new game?
That
yesterday?
I think that's the...
Another game?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
The Great Ace Attorney 2.
Yeah.
Wait a second. What?
You know the Great Ace Attorney, the one that's only in Japan, that wasn't localized? They're making a sequel, it was announced yesterday, I think.
Did they say if it was they were localizing it?
Are you serious?
No, they're not. I mean, they didn't say that they are.
Dang.
You got to be kidding me.
It just makes me mad because I wanted to play the Great Ace Attorney, and I can't.
As it's in stop Japanese. Complaining.
Ah!
It's oh my god, you know what?
Yeah.
That just made my heart ache a little bit.
Oh.
Not even the 3DS part that made my heart ache. But that's all I've been doing. And so, I guess that's all we've been doing. So, time for internet information. Yes, I loaded it, so I'm going to read it from here. You can subscribe to the Lost Levels podcast on iTunes. Make sure to leave us a rating and review. Please leave a rating and review and help us grow and help us appear on the number one page, okay? Yes, true tea. You can find all our past episodes on the website of LostLevels.MariaPartyLexi.com and our news and community about Mario and all the other good stuff, MariaPartyLexi.com. We have a plethora of social networks, so let's get into it. We have Facebook.com/TheLostLevels. That's Facebook. Twitter, LostLevelsMPL. Tumblr, thelostlevelspodcast.tumblr.com, youtube.com/user/thelostlevelsmpl. My credentials and all that good stuff, Nintendo Network DarkBoo007, we have Twitter DarkBoo, and YouTube DarkBoo.
And for me, SuperZambezi on Twitter, Nintendo Network, and YouTube. YouTube is where you can find those Banjo-Kazooie videos.
I am SpiderStaryu everywhere, YouTube, Twitter, Tumblr, Facebook, Nintendo Network, Google+, all of it is SpiderStaryu. Go check it out.
Okay,
and
Soul
can be found.
Yeah, and me. Emmy, you know the drill. It's compete on my meme, the memes, or, yeah. I'm so cool.
And with that, we're done with this podcast. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Bye.
See ya.